So to add a metronome or a click to these tracks, it's really easy to do. All you have to do is in the top left corner of the screen, this is Ableton Live's like metronome control center, everything you need for the metronome. So right here, you could actually tap in a tempo by just tapping it with your mouse. Right here, it shows you the BPM, the beats per minute of the song. So right now we're at 83. We could change that by just clicking and dragging or by clicking and typing in a tempo that you need. And right here, this shows you the time signature. So right now we're in 4/4. And this button right here turns the metronome on and off. So let's turn it on and then let's hit play on one of our songs to see what happens.
Intro 2, 3, 4.
Okay, so the metronome's playing, but it's not in time with the tracks at all. And that's a disaster. So the way to fix this, and the reason why it wasn't on, is because the metronome was playing at 125 BPM. But this is Amazing Grace is at 98 BPM. And so that's why in the audio files, we always name it with the song title, the tempo of the song, and the key. So what we need to do is we need to tell Ableton Live that, okay, when we play This is Amazing Grace, change the tempo to 98. It's really easy to do. All you do is right-click on This is Amazing Grace and go to Edit Launch Tempo. Launch is the same word as play. So we're basically saying, okay, when I launch or play this song, change the tempo to, and I'm going to type in 98 BPM, and you can see that it put that there, 98 BPM. You'll also notice that this little play button turned orange. And anytime you see that happen, it means that that scene has a master tempo control change mapped to it. So it's saying that it's going to actually change the tempo when I hit play. So watch what happens to the metronome.
Intro 2, 3, 4.
If you need to adjust the volume of the metronome, it's adjusted down here with this little blue headphone knob. And now what's really important is that you once you change the tempo on one song, you need to do it for all of them. Because if I go now to this other song and hit play, the metronome is still at 98 because I didn't tell it to change. And see how it's out of time? That's a problem. So let's go ahead and change it. So You Make Me Brave is at 69 BPM. So let's right click on You Make Me Brave and go to Edit Launch Tempo and make this 69. And we'll do the same thing for Unstoppable God. Now, for those of you who like keyboard shortcuts, you can actually just type in all of this at once. So when you're renaming your song, you could do Unstoppable God, semicolon, 132 BPM, and hit Enter. And now, when I play Unstoppable God, the metronome's gonna change to 132, and it's in time with my tracks. You can also adjust the time signature. So for a song like You Make Me Brave, anything that where there's a tempo that's under 100 like that, it might be hard for your drummer to stay in time with a metronome that's like that. So you might want to change the time signature so instead of it's like 1, 2, it's 1 and 2 and something like that. So let's go ahead and right click and go to Edit Launch Time Signature. And now I could type in 2/8 or 4/8, or maybe you have a song like How He Loves, that's in 6/8, you could do that. And let's hit play and see what that sounds like.
1, 2, 1, 2. Three,
so that's a little
four.
Better. You can see the time signature in the top left corner changed to 2/8.
Intro, 2, 3, 4.
And that's it. So that's how you add a metronome and change the tempo and the time signature for your set list.